So I have come up with a list of a very small list of things that I think you should poke your head into, at least sit around for 5 minutes, kind of check out, and then if you want to leave, you can, or just to kind of experience it. And for the most part, almost all of these things are going to be in the hotel portion of the convention center. And since we're moving venues after this year, I think it'd be nice to, kind of just spend a little bit of time in the hotel portion since it hasn't been a part of Otakon for all that long. And also, I think it's going to give you a feel. I don't really know the next place, the next venue that well at all. I think this might give us a good feel for what that might be. So anyway, so here's the very short list of things I think you should check out before Otakon moves away from Baltimore. There is a panel that I've only seen appear once, I think, at Otakon, and it had to do with the kaiju. And there's a group of guys who are really into the kaiju movies. Those are Godzilla and stuff like that. And it was really entertaining, even though their software wasn't working very well, or the convention center software wasn't working very well. But it was still an entertaining panel, and I think if they are there again this year, you should poke your head in and just kind of have a look-see and just have a little good laugh at it. And it's like I said, it's just a neat little thing. Again, I think this is probably going to be in the hotel portion of the convention center. Otakon's manga library is actually pretty cool. I've never really used it before until recently, and one of the reasons why I like it is because it's a really good place to kill some time, especially if you're in between events and there's nothing that you really particularly want to see at that moment. And it's just a good place to unwind a little bit. You just check out a little manga and you read it right there at the table, and once you're done, you hand it back in, and then you go on your merry way. It's really convenient. It's going to be over in the hotel portion. It's one of those small rooms off to the right side of that main hallway there. Just a door or so down from the manga library in the hotel portion of the convention center is a neat little room. I think it's called the UB Blake Room. And it's a neat little room where it just shows like snapshot history of Otakon from the beginning to the current. As you can see, I keep my programs and badges and stuff like that too. And I just think it's a neat little history of Otakon. You should check it out just simply because it's usually it only takes like a couple minutes to go through, but it's just take the time. It's pretty neat, especially when you're able to read some of the stats. It's pretty amazing how far Otakon has come. Most of the live action movies are shown over in the hotel portion of the convention center. And I know we're here for anime, but sometimes they show some movies that are really pretty good. It's where I discovered Ip Man, The Admiral, some other ones that are actually pretty good. Oh, Honey and Clover, which is a really excellent movie based on the manga. And you should avail yourself because they're usually actually quite comfortable rooms to watch an entire movie in. So if you want to give it a chance, I would tell you to do that. So kind of look at the program, see what's over in the hotel portion, and choose your movie.
Ever since they took down the Skywalk connecting the Convention Center to the Bank of America Center, if you were coming from the Convention Center and you wanted to get up to from the ground level to the Skywalk, you had to go down where those stairs are right there, up into the plaza. Well, if you look at the plaza, you can see it's under construction. You can still get around it. I'll show you in a moment. But first, let me just show you. If you are staying at the Sheraton, you're in luck. You can take the Skywalk from directly from the Sheraton to the doors here, over here to the convention center. Otherwise, if you want to get from the convention center to the Inner Harbor, you still want to use the Skywalk, I will show you how to do that. Just know that you can't get from the floor, from the ground floor. You're going to have to go from the second floor of the convention center, cross here, and go over to the Inner Harbor. Okay, in just a moment, we're going to start that journey.
Let the drummer drum.
That was the Skywalk and the Inner Harbor, such as it is now. So, as you can tell, you might want to go along the places along Pratt Street or right outside the convention center to get stuff to eat, of which we'll be talking about in the weeks to come. Speaking of which, next week is going to be an interlude, basically because I'm going to be out of town for the next few days. So there will be just a short little video, so come back, check that out, and then the following week we will have another Where to Eat video, this time much closer to the convention center. Okay, thanks for watching the Unagi Observer. My name is Steve Gearhart, and as always, I will see you guys next time.